In this video, we're going to cover derivatives of inverse trig functions. In other words, derivatives of arcsine, arctan, arccosecant, etc. Let's just do a really quick review of inverse trig functions. Here are a couple graphs of trig functions. We've got sine and cosine and tangent. Now, for the regular functions, we input an x value and we output a y value. Remember that in order to be a function, every x value has to have one corresponding y value. That's also known as the vertical line test, and you'll see all of these functions here satisfy the vertical line test. So they are functions in the first place. Okay, now let's invert the functions. The inverse would be, I pick a y and you tell me what the corresponding x is. In other words, the role of the y and the x are switched. But look at this graph of the sine function. If I pick a y value that was, say, a half, you can see there's two corresponding x values, one here and one over here, and then there's another one because the sine is oscillating and it keeps going. In order to be invertible, a function has to also satisfy the horizontal line test so that every y value corresponds to only one x value. As you can see from the picture, it will satisfy the horizontal line test if we restrict the domain for the sine function to be between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. Let's just consider this little segment right here, and we'll ignore the rest of the sine function. We're just going to throw it away. Same thing with the cosine. If we go from 0 to pi, we'll get the whole length of the cosine, and then the rest of the cosine we can just throw away. The tangent function satisfies the horizontal line test in between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2, so that'll be our restricted domain for tangent. Now, when we find the inverse trig function, we reverse the roles of y and x, which means that we flip the graph about the y equals x line. And here we go. These are the graphs of arcsine, arccos, and arctan. This is, of course, review from pre-calculus, but this is the basic idea for inverse trig functions. Remember that for inverse trig functions, the role of the y and the x are switched, so the domain will change into the range, and the range will change into the domain. Okay, so here's the question we're addressing in this video. Is how do we find the derivatives of inverse trig functions? The first one we're going to look at is arctangent. The derivative of arctangent is 1 over 1 plus x squared. That might sound really random, so what we're going to do is run through a proof of this. You don't have to worry about memorizing the proof, but I want to show you where it comes from, because if you just look at this formula, the derivative of arctan is 1 over 1 plus x squared. It's not really intuitive where this comes from or why the derivative is true. So let's start with y is equal to arctan. The first thing we're going to do is take the tangent of both sides of the equations. As you know, tangent and arctan are inverses of each other, so they sort of undo each other is what we sort of say. So the right-hand side becomes just x because the tan and the arctan cancel out, and then the left-hand side becomes tangent of y. In terms of taking derivatives, tangent of y equals x is a perfectly fine thing to take a derivative of. We can use implicit differentiation, so let's proceed with that. The derivative of the outside function is secant squared. We just copy the y down, and then we multiply times the derivative of the inside function. This is classic implicit differentiation from the previous videos. The derivative of x is 1. Now we can solve for y prime. So dividing by secant squared, we get 1 over secant squared. Now we can use a trig identity. Secant squared is equal to tangent squared plus 1. But remember, tangent of y is equal to x. Isn't this great? Tangent of y can be replaced with an x because that is the relationship we set up in this problem. So there you go. Y prime is equal to 1 over x squared plus 1. That is the proof of the arctan formula. Can you challenge yourself to prove the arcsine formula? What you do is start with y is equal to arcsine. Then take the sine of both sides. Sine and arcsine cancel out, and on the right side you just get x. And then use implicit differentiation. After you use implicit differentiation, you're going to have to use a trig identity, and at the final answer, you're going to get 1 over the square root of 1 minus x squared. Try it at home by yourself. Using similar arguments, you can get this whole list of all of the derivatives of inverse trig functions. If you look carefully at this list, what you'll notice is that the first three derivatives here of arcsine, arctan, and arcsec, these formulas appear again down here for the derivatives of arccos, arctangent, and arccosecant. The only difference between the top three and the bottom three is that the bottom three have extra negative signs out in front, okay? So normally what we do is I just ask that you know the derivative of arcsine is 1 over over the square root of 1 minus x squared, the derivative of arctan is 1 over 1 plus x squared, and the derivative of arcsec, which is 1 over the absolute value of x times the square root of x squared minus 1. You should know these three formulas, okay? And now what you need to remember is that the other three formulas, the coversions or the cofunctions, cosine, cotangent, and cosecant, are the same as the first three, except you add a minus sign in front, okay? So add this onto your list of derivatives. You should know all of these derivatives from this point forward in the course. All right, let's check out a classic example of a product rule. We'll do the derivative of x cubed times arc cosine. We're going to do the product rule, so we're taking the derivative of the first term, multiply times the second, and then the first term, and multiply times the derivative of the second. As you can see, the derivative of arc cos is being utilized here. Okay, we can simplify a little bit, but that's our answer for this case. All right, let's try another one. This one is going to utilize the chain rule. We've got the arctan with log plugged into it. Remember, this is not multiplication. Just read what it says. It says arctan of log base 3. Okay, this is not arctan of x times log base 3 of x. This is composition of functions. Okay, so arctan is the outside function, and we take the derivative of the arctan part. As we covered in the previous slides, is 1 over 1 plus x squared. Now we're going to plug into it the log base 3 and then multiply times the derivative of log base 3. We can simplify a little bit in this case. There's not too much simplification to be done here. And that's our answer. Let's try one with the quotient rule. This time arc cosecant divided by the square root of 1 minus 2x. We will do the bottom times the derivative of the top minus the top times the derivative of the bottom. And moving on for each one of these pieces, the derivative of arc cosecant from earlier is this formula, negative 1 over the absolute value of x squared minus 1. And the derivative of the square root of 1 minus 2x, we've got a square root on the outside, which gives us 1 half parentheses to the minus 1 half power. Remember, we leave the 1 minus 2x inside because that's how the chain rule works, and then we multiply times the derivative of the inside function. And finally, we want to take the denominator and just simplify it. Of course, the square root will cancel with the square. Okay, again, we can do a tiny bit of simplifying here. We've got some 2s canceling out. Since we have this big quantity in the numerator, we can take our denominator and just write 1 over 1 minus 2x in front, and then take the numerator and write it in a slightly simplified form right here. And this is our final answer. So there you go. That's the video for today. You should know the derivatives of all of the inverse trig functions, as is demonstrated on this slide. You should be able to use the inverse trig functions together with the chain rule, the product rule, the quotient rule, and any other functions that we covered in this class. Okay, so check out some extra problems in the book. I hope that you'll challenge yourself to do the homework super early. If you could even start the homework before you come to class, that would be great, because then you would meet the early deadlines, which is extra credit in this class. So don't forget about the early deadlines. I hope everyone will take advantage of the extra credit, and I will see you soon. We're gonna do more of these problems when you get to class. See you then.